Welcome to Family Gamer TV. I'm with Dr. Ben Lewis-Evans at Player Research, and you've been talking about paper prototyping. Now, aren't video games all about electronics and computers? How does paper play a part in all this?
Right, so paper prototyping is an early stage you can do if you're trying to make a game, where you make the game on paper, like with just some pens, paper, some scissors, whatever, game pieces lying around, and you kind of check the basic rules of the game to see if they work and, you know, are they fun before you commit to writing code or making pretty art or anything like that.
And is this something that a proper game developer would do, or is this just something that you do as you're learning how to make games?
Both people learning and also proper game developers will do this. There are several big famous game developers, like I think Sid Meier's, who regularly paper prototype, and they say they have whole cupboards and offices that are just laid out with paper prototypes everywhere of things that haven't worked or things that they're going to get to later. So it is like a very popular method.
So I often get families saying, I've got a son or someone in the family, son or daughter, who would like to get into games. Is this sort of paper prototyping a route into the industry, do you think?
Yeah, I mean, it's really good. Often you can even just do things with just a piece of grid paper and a pencil. You can lay stuff out and then have your friends, whatever, have to move a little token or something through, and you basically try and be the computer. So you set up certain rules, and at certain points things will happen, and you can work out, you know, was that fun? Is it challenging? Other things you can do is you can take existing games, like if you've got board games lying around your house, you can change things about them, like change the way a piece moves in chess, and how does that change the mechanics of chess? Does it make chess better or worse? And that will help you understand why these rules exist in the first place.
Yeah, you just reminded me, actually. My kids took the chess game and replaced the pieces with Skylanders, the little toys, and put a little portal underneath so they lit up. And I hadn't seen that as prototyping, but I guess they were sort of inventing a game there.
Yeah, sure. I mean, that is essentially prototyping. It falls under what's called paper prototyping, but paper prototyping is just really any kind of physical change to a game, a low-level kind of experiment to see how things go, and then you build on the experiment and change things over time to come up with kind of a final product if you can.
I know a lot of commercial games like Disney Infinity, the Toy Box mode, and Little Big Planet, and other games let you develop your own sort of games within limits. Is that a good way to prototype, do you think?
Yeah, that's also a great way to learn. You've already got the tools in front of you, and often the tools are quite user-friendly. You know, if you're already kind of comfortable with the rules of the game, again, you can try and change things, see what you can build within those restrictions. Also, modding is a way to go, like through Steamworks or through games that support modding, like StarCraft. If you think about games like League of Legends or Dota 2, they actually arose out of a mod for Warcraft 3. And it's really interesting because Warcraft 3 had these rules restrictions in them, and when you made the mod, you had to kind of bend those rules, so you've still got these really strange things going on in these games because of their kind of mod background. And this is really good learning. Those games are some of the most popular games in the world now, and that could be something that gets you in the industry, is just making games.
And so to be a good prototyper, what skills or what courses should young people take?
I mean, the great thing about prototyping is there's no courses or anything that you need to take. All you need to do is have an idea for a game and like a piece of paper and maybe a pencil, and you can come up with your own games. And as long as you can try and kind of think like a computer, come up with rules of how this game would work if you want to make it into a digital one, then that's really all you need, just that imagination and the willingness to try.
That sounds great. I want to go home and get my kids on it straight away. Yeah. Thanks for your help. That's really good.
Thank you.